Hello everyone and welcome to today's episode of Beyond the Mask. In this episode today I'm going to be explaining to you guys exactly what happened to the Myers house following the climax of Halloween Kills. Now, a segment at the start of Halloween Ends actually provides us with some detail about the house itself, stating through a news article that the place was demolished following Michael Myers' Halloween killing spree in 2018. What they don't tell you on screen is that there was a purpose and reason to why it was demolished, and how its legacy has actually impacted the people of Haddonfield. This information comes from the novelization of Halloween Ends and also some research into Halloween Kills, with some elements of the Halloween Kills novelization in there as well, so it's jam-packed with information from different sources. The novelization for the third entry in Blumhouse's trilogy really does help provide some great insight into the movie, and I have been covering many aspects of this novel through various videos and will continue to do so. So if you're interested in content like this and want more details on the Halloween franchise particularly, then be sure to hit subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon so you don't miss a single video. So going ahead with the video, the Myers house is somewhat notorious in Haddonfield. You know, from the moment that Michael actually killed his sister Judith in 1963, it was dubbed with so much superstition by the people of the town that it remained unoccupied for years. By the time that we reach Halloween Kills, it had been occupied with a married couple, Big John and Little John. Both were visited and murdered by Michael during his killing spree in 2018, and following this in the house he later murdered Lonnie Elam and his son Cameron, and then he went on to murder Karen, Laurie Strode's daughter. So what exactly happened to the house after this? We know it got demolished, but why and what happened to it afterwards? The town became spooked by 2018's killing spree, and this was a far cry from the events of 1978. You know, this was a really murderous rampage that Michael had gone on this time round. The issue this time was not only that Michael had rampaged through Haddonfield, but he also escaped and was at large. Now, I've done a video detailing about how Michael escaped. You can check that out on my channel right now, or check the description and I will put the link down below for you guys to find the video very easy. But once Michael had vanished, the town seemed to hit more chaos. The FBI came in and a town-wide manhunt was underway, with almost everybody believing that he had either died or he'd just blended into the people of the town and was hiding within plain sight. Now, the house itself, after drawing so much attention and due to its fame and notoriety, was requested to be demolished by the residents with the hopes of erasing the memory of Michael and all the evil that had happened there. In hopes of restoring some kind of peace amongst the community, the location of the house was actually transformed into a memorial garden for the victims who suffered at the hands of Michael Myers over the years. It was a nice gesture initially. The garden seemed like a great bid for closure. However, the memory of Michael loomed over Haddonfield like a ghost. The garden was rarely visited and fell into a state of disrepair. It was unkept and abandoned, a local area for teens to vandalise and hang out. Allison stepped over beer cans, cigarette butts and other litter that made the garden its home. She looked at the imposing raw iron sign that lived on the entrance, the one that read, "Love Lives Today." Like everything else in the garden, the fixture stood unnaturally, bent by the elements. Vines curled around the post and twisted through the letters like they were strangling it and bringing it to hell. On the plot of land where evil lived, life struggled to grow. The whole area was pretty much just left. Despite it being a memorial garden, people just didn't want to be reminded of this dark past, a dark past that they were trying to forget. The legacy of the Myers house would continue to loom over Haddonfield despite it being demolished, and I do believe the fact that Michael remained hidden gave the residents a silent sense of dread. Dread that he would one day return. With the common denominator between his three attacks in the town being the Myers house and his desire to return to it, it felt like Haddonfield was stripping away the connection to Michael and removing any reason for him to return. And thus the legacy of Michael Myers and the Myers house itself would continue to stalk and haunt Haddonfield until Michael was killed, and following this maybe they finally let go of the hate and the dread they felt in connection to the Myers house. Just for fun, how many of you can name every single victim from Blumhouse's timeline that likely had a place in the memorial garden? Share your knowledge down below. I cannot wait to hear how many of you actually know all of the victims from 1963 all the way to 2018. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like the video. That lets me know that you're enjoying this content. Closing off the video, I'm going to leave it on a quote from the Halloween Ends trailer.
But this time, something feels different. He's more dangerous.